Tonight on the July edition of Wolf Tracks, we bring you the best stories done by the beginning students in the year 2004, and the recipe for some tasty chicken Alfredo.
Good evening and welcome to the July edition of Wolf Tracks, and the first ever dinner in a Wolf Tracks, which means not only quality stories produced by students, but also a good dinner later on in the show.
But before we get to the chicken Alfredo, let's take a look at our first story, bad jobs. We've all had bad jobs, Zach. But so have our parents and teachers, too. So don't feel too bad.
Professional box folding.
I have to clean up the feces of my customers.
Washing people's cars.
Yeah, those are really bad jobs. So what's up with that? Don't we teens have enough problems already? You know, going to school, doing chores, and all that stuff? Then we have to put up with all these lousy jobs no one else will do.
I really don't think I'd be qualified for very much. Maybe a busboy or some job at a fast food restaurant.
So lack of experience in schooling is probably the reason why teens are cooking burgers, mopping floors, and carrying heavy stuff around all day. But if it makes you feel any better, this lousy job thing has been going on for a long time. I checked with some of our school staff members and found out what kind of lousy jobs they used to have.
I had this nasty job of going to work at 3 o'clock in the morning and going in these things and catching chickens with my bare hands.
And plus, they had to walk uphill in the snow both ways. So I guess teens in 2004 aren't the only ones doing the dirty work. But I was curious, just like now, they did the lousy jobs for money, right? But did they get anything else from the experience?
I do think that being employed as a teenager is important to becoming a productive member of society.
Bad jobs or not, it's still worth it to become a good citizen. And plus, nowadays, minimum wage isn't even that bad. So take to heart, everybody. Doing all those dirty jobs may be just the kind of work experience that will help you land a cushy job someday.
Hey, that guy that was catching chickens, he's our video teacher. Weird.
Before we get to our next story, let's introduce our guest host, David Bronstein, and see what he's up to.
Good evening, I'm David Bronstein, and tonight we're making chicken Alfredo. I got the recipe from www.allrecipes.com. So if you miss a step, go there and search chicken Alfredo. Now right now it's time to get out a piece of paper and something to write with, because after this next story, I'm going to be telling you what the ingredients are.
Well, it's kind of ironic. Listening to David makes me hungry, and so does this next story.
The student store. It's a great place, right? All sorts of candy treats supplied to you at a great price. But not only is the store for the students, it's run by the students. So what do the students that work there think of the student store? Well, it just so happens that I asked them.
It's kind of hectic sometimes. It's pretty fun, though. Once you get used to it, though, it's kind of like, it gets fun. It's better than sitting around in class all day.
It's fun. It usually is a lot of hard work, but it's something that comes easy, I guess, now, since I've done it for 2 years. So
it gives the students an opportunity to get hands-on work experience in retail and food management. And it also helps people like me deal with stress. It gives me an outlet. We get an opportunity to work with the school board on how to sell healthy items, and usually we lose.
So the students seem to enjoy working there. How about the actual products? I asked students what their favorite treat was to buy from the student store.
It's nice when the student store has Starbucks Frappuccinos.
Well, I'm rather partial to the cup of noodles because I think it's a good supplement to a lunch if you don't have one.
I like breadsticks. Bags of chips or muffins? I like the muffins.
Cosmo brownies.
I like the hot dogs.
The Little Debbie snacks.
I do indeed like my muffins.
So, opinions seem to be varied on the best student store snack, but what about the least favorite?
I haven't run into one yet.
Everything there is great. So, I don't have anything I don't like.
Those fake brownie squares. Because they're probably not real brownie.
Star crunches, I guess?
The Little Debbie shortcakes.
Everything other than muffins, especially breadsticks.
Anything with sugar and carbs!
Dislikes seem to be varied too. But that's probably due to the wide variety of products that the student store sells. Products range from breadsticks to hot dogs, milk duds, nutty bars, chocolate chip cookies, Cheetos, Junior Mints, Rolos, Twix. The list goes on and on. Lots of goodies, right? You want all this great stuff, don't you? Then break open your piggy bank and bring that fat wad of cash down to the student store. spending never tasted so good.
Well, being a guy and loving selection, I'm going to devote myself to trying one of everything at the student store. Okay, all this talk about food. Let's see if David can hurry up with my dinner.
Now that we're ready to start cooking, let's take a look at the most important step of all, the ingredients. 6 skinless, boneless chicken breast halves cut into cubes. 6 teaspoons of butter, divided. 4 cloves of garlic, minced. 1 tablespoon Italian seasoning. 1 pound fettuccine pasta. 1 onion, diced. 1 8-ounce package sliced mushrooms. 1/3 cup all-purpose flour. 1 tablespoon of salt. 3 cups of milk. 1 cup of half and half. 3/4 cup grated Parmesan cheese. 8 ounces of Monterey Jack cheese. Yet again, we're still not cooking, but be patient, because in the end, it'll all be worth it.
The first time we saw this story, we thought the title was Smoking Burns, but actually Burns is the last name of the kid who produced it. But we decided to leave it since the message is so close to his heart.
Last month, you may have noticed a giant cigarette walking the halls of SK. Did you ever ask yourself why? Every year there is a National Kick Butt Week, a fight against tobacco. But why? Did you know that 2000 teens start smoking every day? And that... Many people look down on smoking, even our own peers. Here are the opinions of some SK students.
I think smoking is bad. And why? Because all it does is kill you. It's like a cancer stick. It's an easier way to die.
Have you ever tried smoking?
No, I would never try smoking. It's disgusting because you smell really bad.
Hi, my name is Chris. You may see smoking infomercials every day, but they don't affect you much, do they? You probably just think, oh, they're just actors. They're not real. But I want you to meet my grandma. She's a very real person with a very real message.
The first time I ever smoked, I got dizzy and I couldn't walk straight. But after that, I got over that feeling, and it was just something you did all the time because everybody else did it, and it became a habit. I've had asthma and emphysema, and I had a quadruple bypass. And when I had that surgery done, they extracted a 3-liter bottle of yucky brown liquid out of my lungs. So I thought, this is not a savings account or something to be good. I think the best way that you have to do it is you have to quit cold turkey. And it's terrible. You get really mean and angry and you snap at everybody, but you have to hold out and not give in to it, or you'll be smoking the rest of your life and you won't have too long of a life.
Smoking kills. Did you notice the counter in the corner of your screen? This many people died of tobacco-related cause in the short time that you watched this video. Now, do you want to light up?
After watching this story, I think we all should think twice about letting your loved ones smoke.
Well, I think it's time to get cooking. Let's see what David's up to.
Finally, it's time for us to start cooking. In a large skillet over medium heat, combine the chicken, the 2 tablespoons of butter, the garlic, and the Italian seasoning. Cook until the chicken is no longer pink. Remove from the skillet and set aside. Well, I hope you got all that because it's time to get back to the stories.
I like to feel safe, and we can all feel safe here at South. South's security cameras watch over us. Let's see what others think as well.
Have you ever looked up and wondered, where are those domes above our heads?
Because at first I didn't know what they were, and I saw these little black things coming out of the ceiling, and I was like, what are those?
Well, they're cameras. And here at SK, you'll see them everywhere, from hall to hall, and even the parking lot, all here to protect and watch over us. Here at SK, since the early 80s, the students have been watched over. But by a guardian angel, you ask? No. The cameras here at SK have that job. Well, has anyone ever asked how the students at SK feel about this?
It's kind of scary that people watch you wherever you go, but nah, I guess they need it because some people don't follow the rules of
security
school,
cameras
so.
are there for a reason, and it doesn't really bother me much that they're there.
They're okay, but they really kind of bug me because I don't think they need to know what I'm doing.
And that's how the students feel. But what about the SK administrators?
To my knowledge, it's worked beautifully, but again.
Okay, they work well, but how do they work?
Cameras. We have a multitude of cameras that are throughout the building and also on the outside of the building. And they are set to scan probably four or five different areas, each individual camera.
And since they work so well, they catch criminal activity all the time.
Individuals that were involved with stealing the different equipment and stuff here in the building, and you know, it's able to kind of zoom in, and a lot of times you can tell exactly who the individual is.
Well, next time you're walking around the halls of SK and you're thinking about stealing, remember, they're watching you.
Well, everyone has different opinions on being watched by Big Brother.
Anyways, last time we saw David, he was cooking the chicken. I think it's time for some carbs.
Bring a large pot of lightly salted water to a boil. Add pasta and cook for 8 to 10 minutes until done. Well, while these noodles are cooking, I think we should take a break.
Great, a couple of lovebirds. Where do you think you're going?
Now, if this story doesn't make you smile, Zach, then you've got more problems than we already thought. It's about some students at South that love to make the lives of others even more special, no matter the age gap.
This is landscaping, a class run by Mrs. Watson. In this class, the students get to transplant and prune plants around the school, but that's not all they do. Every 2 weeks, this class goes to Stafford Suites, a retirement home, and do projects with the residents.
I think coming here is great, actually, because you can learn a lot from old people. It's good to talk to them. They're fun.
I like coming to Stafford Suites because it gives us an opportunity to work with people that are a lot more older and knowledgeable than us, and it gives us an opportunity to serve our community while getting credit for school.
Exchange ideas of how to plant or whatever they're endeavor is of the day.
When the students come for garden club, they interact with the residents and make Christmas wreaths, make things for Thanksgiving to hang on their doors. Today they're repotting. Are they repotting plants or doing seedlings?
What do the students do when they come here?
Talk a lot.
The students, they bring this stuff in, they interact with our residents, and just kind of make their day a little better.
Yeah, yeah.
I think it's the most wonderful thing that could possibly happen. I really do. Because I think everybody that's here enjoys having youth around us because we've lost all of our youthfulness.
What do you think about the students coming here to Stafford?
Well, I think...
Is it a good thing or a bad thing?
That's a good thing, I think. If they come here and act like they do now, they smile and they do work. Sure, they do just...
They're kind of scary at first, but they kind of grow on us.
Oh, yeah. They grow on you. Yeah, they grow on you.
So school is great when you're learning new skills, but even better when you can use those skills to help.
Isn't it great to see kids caring so much about the elderly?
Yeah. Well, the pasta is done, and so is the chicken. So let's see what's keeping me from my dinner.
Now, since those noodles aren't quite ready yet, let's go on to the next step. Melt 4 tablespoons of butter in the skillet. Saute the onions, 2 tablespoons garlic, and the mushroom until the onions are transparent. Stir in the flour and salt, and cook for 2 minutes.
Did you know that cooking is a type of art? Well, a woodshop might not sound like an art class, but it actually is. Let's take a look at this next story.
Woodshop. Lots of death and extremely loud. There are many creative and challenging projects from this class, but Mr. Schaefer only expects 9 things from his students. Woodshop has a $20 shop fee to help pay for all of the materials. Otherwise, Woodshop is just like any other class at this school. They have bookwork, projects, and daily work. Most of their tests are shop safety tests.
But anyway, it's a real fast class. It only is a trimester. We offer it a couple times, or all 3 trimesters a year.
Now, why would someone want to be in this class?
Because guys don't think that girls like me would be in this class.
The students here enjoy being in Mr. Schaefer's class.
He's the coolest guy in the world. He's always there to help you. He's a good guy.
Not only do they have a beginning woodshop, but also cabinet making and construction. I hope this video has inspired you to take this class. Woodshop, it's a wonderful world.
Well, yet another thing I learned about the students here at South. I think I'm going to ask one of them to make me a dresser for my room.
I hope you're all as hungry as I am, because we only have 2 more steps until the final product. So Leah, milk it half and half, constantly stirring until smooth and creamy. Well, we only have 1 more step, but we're going to take a look at that after this next story.
Now, school elections used to look like a talent show, but since then things have gotten more professional.
What is this, an old talent show? These people sure are funny. Wait a second, these are just the old class elections. Back in the day, class candidates did their speeches at assemblies, where students had to get out of class and listen to what they had to say. But this created one apparent problem.
Stands for Associated.
Now that we have WTV, speeches are broadcasted this year over the morning announcements, hopefully giving voters a better feeling of what the candidates' plans for the school are. What do people think of these new speeches?
Assemblies are better than WTV because you can see people's personalities more than when they're just reading off cue cards. So I think they should stay in assemblies.
I think I like much better because the acoustics are a lot better, so you can actually understand what the people are saying, and it gives you more of a one-on-one feeling with the candidate rather than having...
Mr. Ogan, the man behind the plan, explains.
Ms. Nash and I talked about it with Mr. Downham and just thought there would be a way of kind of making the speeches a lot more serious, adding more professionalism to the ASB elections, and making it so that the kids running weren't out just kind of pandering to the crowd and being funny and cute, that they were actually giving real good serious speeches about how they could help our school.
Now we all want to know, will the speeches be done the same way next year?
We're going to have to evaluate that, get comments back from the staff and the students about how they felt it went, and obviously it put a lot of stress on Mr. Downham and the video production crew, trying to get all those speeches edited and put together and filmed and see how that works for him and make a decision about that next year.
Only time will tell what happens next year. Will we do it the old way or the new way?
And I'm running for senior class president.
That's pretty inspirational. I think I'm going to run to be the first woman president.
Of the Tupperware Club? The last step is finally here. Let's see if David's done yet with my dinner.
The moment has finally arrived. The last step for cooking our chicken Alfredo. The cheese. Stir in the Parmesan and Monterey Jack cheese. Stir until the cheese is melted. Add the chicken mixture and serve over the cooked fettuccine. Now my dish is done, but while I'm preparing the rest of the dishes for our other two hosts, we're going to take a look at this next story.
There's a new sport floating around here in Port Orchard. Heck, I might even try it. Let's take a look at this next story.
You've seen extreme sports. New Orleans Red, Austin. Well, get ready for the newest element. The back, not full extension. Trampoline. This
what?
Is a trampoline board.
Where you take,
it has
like,
no wheels and the edges are duct taped to keep it from ripping
and
holes
go on
in
the trampoline
and
bounce up and down and do and stuff.
But trampoline boarding isn't exactly new. People have been doing it for years. It seems, however, that now it's finally starting to catch on. One reason could be that it's so easy. Another reason kids trampoline skateboard is that it helps them get better at the real sport. Trampoline does help you get better because you get used to the motions and it feels more natural to you.
But I'm sure when I start, it's going to be a lot easier because I use a trampoline skateboard.
I've snowboarded on trampoline, I've wakeboarded on trampoline, I've even unicycled on trampoline.
Trampoline sports are catching on because they're easy and also a means of practice. So even if you're no good at extreme sports, you should give trampoline boarding a try.
Trampoline sports, huh? Sounds interesting. Hey, maybe trampoline sales will double, or we'll even have a new extreme sport.
Maybe. Well, that's it for the July edition of Wolf Tracks. We hope you enjoyed everything, the knowledge, and the food. I'm Stephanie Mott.
I'm Zach Riddle.
I'm David Brownstein, and that's it for this edition of Wolf Tracks.